Well, before Aurora, there was Columbine, the school shooting in 1999, also outside Denver. It killed 12 students and one teacher. Two students were to blame in that attack. Craig Scott was wounded that day. His sister, Rachel, she was killed. Craig sat down with CNN to talk about the theater shooting in Aurora and offer his advice to the victims to help them try to move past the tragedy.
I think they can expect times of obviously sadness and grief, and expect times where they're questioning why this happened. Expect times where they'll see the shooter's face and they're going to feel very angry. For the people that were in the theater that are going to have post-traumatic stress disorder symptoms, they might have problems with their memory. They might have nightmares, paranoid feelings. They might have survivor's guilt. And all of those things can heal over time. And there are definite things that you can do to heal. And there are friends that I have today from Columbine that are still struggling. I have friends that are still in a very negative place. I have friends that didn't want to deal with it. I had friends that wouldn't talk about it, that ran away from it. And I've talked to some of them. Some of them regret that. And I didn't do that. I felt like it was too important to run away from. I wasn't going to let fear hold me back. I've heard talk of from people, I'm scared to go to the theater at night now, and I understand that, but I would say don't let fear hold you back. Don't let this shooter rob you from anything that he's already robbed people enough. And not just things like going to the movies, but if people aren't careful, they can let him rob them of peace, joy, life. They can be turned into a bitter person because of this or a better person because of this. And I truly hope that they can become better, stronger, deeper because of what happened. Well, I would say to all of the survivors that were in the room together, they have a special bond that nobody else in the world shares. And I would really hold on to that bond. I would say get to know everybody that was in that room. I didn't do that with all of the people that I was in the library with, which was the scene of the most intense shooting at Columbine. And we were trapped like they were. We thought it was a prank at first. And we feared for our lives. And I wish that I had stayed in contact with all of them, but I didn't. And to this day, I still wonder what some of them experienced, because your memory starts to get a little fuzzy. It is harder when the cameras leave, when there is no more attention, when it seems you've lost some support and you're alone, and now you're dealing with this situation. The sense of comfort that you get when you have a lot of people coming rallying around you is incredible, and that will dwindle over time. And so I would say prepare for when you go through tragedy and you have that initial support. I would say prepare for the days ahead when you're going to be alone and it's just going to hit you in a different way, and that sadness is really going to be concrete. But you know what? There is a light on the other side, and you can get through your loss, and you can get through, and you can come out shining. You can come out smiling. I want to share one story. After Columbine, I went to South Africa for a couple of months, and I had this driver, this big African man who was always singing songs and really joyful. And one night I kind of felt sorry for myself and I shared with him my story. And in turn, he shared with me his story. And he came home to find 17 members of his family slaughtered. His wife, his kids, his siblings, his relatives. It was during the apartheid in South Africa. And what struck me was that he told me his story with a smile. Not a fake smile, a genuine smile. And what I never forgot about this man was that life circumstances can't rob you of your inner life unless you let it. This is a man who lost everything and chose to continue on. And I would say, you've suffered tremendous loss. You're going to suffer a lot of sadness and a lot of emotions. But don't let it define you in a negative way. Let it be a catalyst for you becoming a greater person. Maybe the person that you've longed to be for a long time. My family and I, after Columbine, it was years after doing a lot of speaking and media interviews that we finally started Rachel's Challenge, which is a program that reaches schools with my sister's story. And we share a story of a girl who believes she can make a difference through acts of kindness. And she believes she could start a chain reaction of compassion, where if one person did something kind for another, it could have a ripple effect on other people. But it took time, work, and it kind of happened organically. And now the organization is the largest of its kind in the country and will speak to 4 million people this year in person. And so if someone has just, they want to do something, they're not sure what, they want to make something good, I would say follow your heart. I would say that you have a platform right now. People want to hear from you. Take advantage of that platform. There's nothing to be ashamed of doing media interviews and going out and speaking in public. It's not about you. It's about the message that you have to share.